Filipino workers in Taiwan set to receive a pay hike next year. Meanwhile, more Filipino workers are in demand in Japan and South Korea. Zen Hernandez tells us more.
Overseas Filipino workers in Taiwan are expected to benefit from a new minimum wage law that not only affirms a recent wage increase, but also formalizes and enhances minimum wage adjustment procedures. For factory worker Federico Gonzalez, who had to work on Christmas Day, this is very welcome news.
Joyful kasi syempre, every year dito sa Taiwan, masaya kami kasi every year nagtataas ng salary dito. Kahit pa paano, nadadagdagan yung salary na in-expect namin.
Starting January 1, 2024, the new minimum wage in Taiwan will become 27,470 new Taiwan dollars, or over 46,000 pesos, after an increase of over 1,000 NT. The new law also stipulates that a 21-member committee headed by the Ministry of Labor must convene every third quarter of the year to review the minimum wage and recommend possible adjustments. This will be based heavily on the Consumer Price Index, but also on factors such as per capita income, gross domestic product growth, and minimum living expenses. The law also imposes a heftier fine for non-compliance. Manila Economic and Cultural Office Chairman Silvestre Bello III lauded the initiative, which is beneficial to all workers, including Filipinos. According to MECO, over 123,000 Filipino workers will benefit from the new law, including those hired until the end of 2023. Aside from Taiwan, more opportunities are also expected to open up for Filipinos in Japan as the Department of Migrant Workers launched its Japan desk in Tokyo and Osaka. The Japan desk was an idea by the late Secretary Susan Ople, who wanted a more streamlined facilitation of employment for Filipinos.
Marami na po kaming natatanggap ng mga requests from the delegations in Japan. Nakikita po nila talaga na ang Pilipino ay seryoso pagdating sa hindi lamang po sa pagtatrabaho, no? But doon sa pagtatrabaho sa Japan.
There are currently over 61,000 registered Filipino workers in Japan, mostly working as construction, manufacturing, and care workers. The DMW is aiming for around 200,000 positions to open up for Filipinos and make OFWs the number one choice for Japanese employers. Aside from Japan, the DMW is also in talks with South Korea for a pilot program on the deployment of Filipino care workers. Applicants are once again reminded, however, to deal only with licensed recruitment agencies and go through the legal process. The DMW may be reached through their official website and social media accounts. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
An airport employee caught escorting human trafficking victims in Manila's main gateway, the Bureau of Immigration said. The employee at the Naia Terminal 3 accompanied three passengers who attempted to depart for Dubai in the United Arab Emirates last December 22. The victims claim they were recruited as household workers through Facebook. The Inter-Agency Council Against Trafficking is digging deeper into the incident. It's the latest controversy involving airport personnel at the Naia. In the past, some of the employees were caught stealing cash and other valuables of passengers. The armed forces of the Philippines gearing up on various fronts in enhancing the defense posture of the country. Colonel Midel Aguilar says while government is putting a premium on boosting maritime security due to China's aggression, the AFP's modernization will also focus on enhancing cybersecurity. Without giving specifics, Aguilar said there are current cyber threats that can be considered national security concerns.
Most of our projects in the modernization program will upgrade the capability of our aerial and maritime operations. So we expect more vessels, we expect more aircrafts. We also looking at improving our radar system, the capability to detect intruders. These are all in the pipeline already. We are also enhancing our cyber capability. There are so many hacks already being conducted by some notorious individuals, and we cannot allow this to happen, especially in the military establishment.
Colonel Aguilar says the AFP will do what is necessary and legal in countering China's actions in the West Philippine Sea. This as Beijing continues to accuse Manila of deliberately provoking China and infringing on its sovereignty. The AFP also preparing for possible retaliatory attacks by rebels after a Christmas Day clash in Bukidnon. 10 rebels were killed in that encounter, which took place even after the Communist Party declared a two-day unilateral truce. The AFP insists that declaration was meaningless. It adds, while the Philippine government and the National Democratic Front agreed to hold exploratory talks for possible peace negotiations, the military will continue to pursue remaining armed groups.
We are always ready for any eventuality, for any hostility that may be launched by any armed group. And right now, when you talk about the CPP and PA, they are on the run. When you talk about the encounter in Bukidnon, you will see that the casualties there could be coming from the members of this Subregional Committee 2 of the North Central Mindanao Revolutionary Committee and its armed group. So therefore, we are already attacking the leadership, the top leadership of the CPP-NPA in that particular region.